Hi everybody, this is Oksana, and today we're going to make this fun little pendant. Before we get started, I just want to say a huge thank you to Rio Grande for sponsoring this video. I love using their wire. This is their copper wire that you see here, and they also have these cute little copper beads that you see here as well, which make awesome little accents to my wire wrapped pieces. So without further ado, let's get started.
We are starting with 3 pieces of 21 gauge square dead soft copper. It looks like this from riograande.com. And if your stone is a little bigger, feel free to size up to 20 gauge. It'll be a little thicker, but my stone is quite small, so I'm using a thinner wire. And the wires measure 12 inches. And my stone, it's quite a little round stone here. It's a moonstone. And it's more than half an inch. It's about 16 millimeters here. But it doesn't have to be this small. Feel free to use a larger stone. And if you don't have a round stone, you can use an oval, and that'll work well with this design also. So for my thinner wire here, I'm going to be using this half round wire. It's 24 gauge, also from Rio Grande. Here's what it looks like. Nice thin wire. And this is what I'm going to be using to connect my other wires together. So you just want to grab your wires just roughly in the middle. And in that middle portion, we are going to use the half round wire. And we're going to wrap it around. Just grab a tail end of it. This is still connected to the spool. I did not cut it in case I need to use more of it. But I just grab a little end and I wrap it around a bunch of times to make sure I get a nice sturdy connection. If your little tail end runs out quickly, then you can use this part as well. You would just guide the wire and then turn these three wires like this. Once you're satisfied with the length of this, it's probably about 10 millimeters or so, we are just going to trim our little wires here so that the ends are both on the same side. And then you just want to press on that to press those little ends down and just the whole thing. Go over the whole thing. And what we're going to do now is we are going to bend it. I'm just pressing them a little closer together. So the way you want to bend it is at an angle, and you want the wire ends here to kind of be inside and then the point to be here on the part that does not have the wire ends. So I'll show you. So I'm bending it, forming an angle. The wire ends are inside. This portion does not have the wire ends. So let's go ahead and make that a little sharper. It's easier for me to kind of hold it upside down like this. And you might have to perfect it a little bit to try to get it even with this little wrap that we have on here. But basically, just like this. And now you just want to take your stone, and we are gonna hold the stone in here like this so that there's gonna be a little bit of a gap. This is going to be the bottom of the pendant, so there's going to be a gap on the bottom of the pendant. Just going to open this up a little bit. There we go. I just don't want to have like a huge gap. This is good. And now we're going to bend the wires. Feel free to put this down on like a flat surface, like a table. That'll make it much easier to bend than doing it in the air like me. I just want you guys to be able to see it well here. And then at the top, we're bringing these wires together, three wires on each side. So if you remove the stone, this is the frame. Now we're just going to take that half round wire again, and we are going to wrap it around all 6 wires. So there's 3 wires on each side for a total of 6 of these little wire ends. So I'm just wrapping the little end of it first, and then you just scooch this down and then take that little end and put it from back to front and just kind of pull on that a little bit and trim that off. So now we're going to press on that. And by the way, if this is going a little bit too quick for you, and you might be doing this for the very first time, this type of frame with the square wires, I do have a really good beginner tutorial. The design ends up being a little bit different, but it just very slowly goes over each step in detail. So it's really good for beginners, and I'll link that tutorial as well. So I'm going to take the backmost wires and I'm going to separate them from the other wires. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring this half round wire to the back here, and I'm going to wrap around these back 2 wires like this. And I'm just going to do that for a little bit until it's tall enough to be my bail. So I'll come back in just a minute. And then the way you want to trim the wire when you're done is you want to trim it here on this side. So this is the front of our pendant. This is the side that you see here, and that's where you want the wire end to be. And then we're just going to press on that whole thing, including that little wire end. All right, so this is the length that mine ended up. I'll measure it for you, but feel free to make your bail larger or smaller. So it is about 3/4 inch or 20 millimeters. And what we're gonna do now is we're gonna separate these other wires into their respective sides. So these 2 that are on this side, we're just gonna push them to that side, and then these are gonna go to this side. And before we finish this and make the bail, I just like to lock my stone in at this point. So to lock in the stone, you just wanna pop it into the frame. And I'm sorry, I forgot to go over the tools needed, so I'll do that now. So you just need wire cutters to cut the wire. These are mine. They're the Swanstrom tools from Rio Grande, and they come in a kit. So if you buy the kit, then you'll have pliers and all that other stuff. But then the other thing that you need is pliers. And so these are my pliers that I'm using. They're Lindstrom RX7890. So this is the portion where I'm gonna use my pliers. I'm gonna just bend these wires that are on the back like this to block the stone from popping out. And the same thing on the other side as well. All right, so that's the back. And for the front, I'm just gonna wedge them in here. And this very frontmost wire, that's the wire I'm gonna bend. So I'm just pushing down until I get to this little wrap here. And then I just turn my wrist and put in this little bend here. And I'm gonna do that on the other side as well. And that is how we lock in our stone. All right, so this is gonna be our bail. That's why we needed the little wire end to be here, because once we curve this, it's going to be hidden inside of the bail. So I am bending it forward into a bail shape like this. And now I'm going to take the rightmost wire and I'm just going to give it a little curve, curving it this way from right to left. And then I'm gonna take the other wire and I am going to also curve it. So you can have it go along the other wire like this, forming that kind of swirl. Or You can make this second swirl a little bit smaller and kind of push it this way for this kind of look. It's up to you what you prefer. Those are kind of the two different looks that you can get. I'm just trying to press down on this a little bit with my pliers to get it. There we go. Get it a little bit down in there. All right, so it's gonna swoop across, and then this other one is going to also swoop across like this. And here on the back, we are gonna trim those wires, and we are gonna be tucking away these little wire ends. So first the one on the bottom, tuck it in there and press down on it. And then the next one, tuck it in, press it down. So now they're connected. All right, now just for fun, I am going to twist the wire. So to twist the square wires, it can only be done with square, holding the wire with my pliers and just turning the piece, and you can see that twisted pattern starting to form in the wire. Now you can leave it like this, or you can twist it some more for a tighter twist. Just feel free to stop at any time when it has the kind of look that you are going for. And I'm going to do this on this side, and I'm going to do it on the other side as well. Just pick whatever wire, it doesn't really matter. I'm just going to do the back wire here. It's just for looks, and if you don't like the look of twisted wire, you of course do not need to do this part. All right, coming back to the front here, I am going to work on the wires that are on the right side. So here's the two wires. This one is in the front. So I'm going to take that one first, and I'm going to curve it alongside these other swirls here. And then the next wire, I'm going to have that going alongside there as well, like this. And when they are here on the side, I'm just going to press on them with my thumb, and I'm going to keep curving them so they are going along the edge of my stone. And then we're going to take these ends, we're just going to lift this whole piece up a little bit so that we can take the ends and tuck them in here into this little gap. That's why we needed that little gap on the bottom there. And as you pull them through, just do it very slowly and carefully, because you don't want to mess up their shape, since we kind of shape them around the edge there. If you just pull on them really hard, you might destroy that little curve that we made. All right, so once they are through and they're still looking good here, so now we're going to lock this part in place. So I'm trimming them, but I'm leaving myself a wire end. I'll show you in a second what that wire end is for, so you can determine how long to leave. So you want just a little bit of length here, because you want this wire end to kind of come around this way and to reach, so you can kind of tuck it away like this into here. And then same thing with the other wire. I curved it, and now I'm pressing down on it. So now the wire end isn't sticking up. It's kind of pointing down in there and you can't feel it. All right, so now with this side, we have two wires here. This one is in the front and the twisted one is in the back. So what you want to do is kind of start to curve them, but we are going to tuck them in here on the back through this gap like this. So as you're pulling them through, it's probably best to do one at a time. I'm trying to go nice and slow so that I can get a nice little curve here. If you just yank it, it might kind of mess up that curve. And this way I'm also like pressing on it, making sure it's laying down nicely to form this little curve here. So then once you have that, I'm just gonna run them through my fingers and get them lined up nicely together like this. I'm gonna press on the little curve so it's not too far back. And then I'm gonna take these wires and I'm gonna bend them down. And I'm just gonna have them go alongside the edge here, just like on that side, except on this side. So just like that. And you can either tuck them in to the gap, just like we did on the other side, or option number two is to have them go across the gap, bend them like this, trim and leave yourself little ends, and then take the little ends and tuck them in there to make a connection. So one and two. So that gives you this kind of look. So it's up to you whether you want it to go like this or just to be like this side. And then for a little special touch at the end here, I'm just gonna add a little bead. These are from Rio Grande, 3mm copper beads here, seamed beads. And you are just gonna need a little piece, just a few inches long, maybe like 4 or 5 inches of the half round wire that you're gonna put your bead on. And with this step, you can attach any beads anywhere you want for decoration. What I'm gonna do is I noticed there's a little gap right here above my stone that is large enough for me to kind of want to cover it up with a bead, but it's also small enough where the bead isn't going to pop through. But you just look at your own design. There's other options as well. Like there's a little gap right here that would look really nice with a bead. You can put a bead in both places. There's a gap here, but it's quite small. If I were going to put a bead here, I'd probably use a smaller bead, because this bead is quite large for that gap. So feel free to do any of that. You can even add one down here. You can add just a whole bunch of beads to this pendant. Actually, I really like the look of that, so I might add one both places. I don't know, we'll see. We're gonna start with this gap. This is the one that was kind of calling to me. So I'm popping it through here, and then I have my two wires that are in the back. So I'm just going to kind of crisscross them. So we have this one. I'm just gonna put it on this side and the other one on the other side so that I can attach them, basically. Just separating the wires while I'm pressing down on the bead, because nothing is holding this bead right now. But once I start to wrap the wires, it will hold it in place. So I'm gonna take this one first and just wrap it around. Let's see, I might need to raise this wire a tiny smidge so I can get in there and wrap around this backmost wire. So I'm just gonna pull on that. And before I finish it, I'm gonna do same thing on this side with this wire. And the reason I did that is so that they are both wrapped around at least once, and now my bead is kind of staying put, and now I can finish this up. So to finish it up, I would wrap around a few times, maybe like 4 times or so would be adequate. And then after I do that, I'll be able to trim my wires here. So that's good. Got a few wraps going there. Let's do the other side. All right, and now we just trim. So I'm just trimming and leaving myself a little wire end that I can tuck away, and then with my pliers, I'm just taking that little wire end and just kind of turning it downwards and pressing down on it, and it gets tucked away. And same thing here, turn and press it down in there. So I am going to add one more bead down here in this little gap because I think that looks cool. So all you do here, same thing. Here's our little wires coming out. I like to just kind of crisscross them because by doing so, I have the rounded side up, flat side down. And then when I wrap it, it's kind of like the way you normally use half round wire, where the flat side is wrapping up against the wire and the rounded side is facing you. And I did once around that wire. Now I'm doing once around this wire just to kind of stabilize the bead and lock it in place. And once you do that, you just go back and wrap each one of these wires around just this backmost wire here, just at least 4 times to make a nice sturdy connection. All right, so I got that one wrapped around. Now I'm gonna do the one on this side. Go ahead and do that. And now I just trim them. Like this, and then I'm taking the little wire ends, turning them down and pressing on them to tuck them away on each side here. There we go. So that is done. And now we have 2 little beads here on the front, and I think it looks really cute. So that's it. That is the finished piece. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, give me a like down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.